but you do see some blue. The Cubs travel away. And Watson just hit Arrieta. Now Arrieta's hit a couple of pirates, and now we've got the Chicago bench emptying and words being exchanged, and here come the Pirates. And for a couple of teams that met 19 times this year, things are getting vocal. That's all it is at this point.
Well, you can see the side of the Pittsburgh Pirates. What they're saying is, you've hit two of our players, and you did it, Jake Arrieta. So we're going to try to get back at you. As you can see, Garrett Cole trying to get involved. Arrieta's been pushed out of the scrum. But you can see it from Chicago. They're saying to themselves, hey, we need this guy to move along in the postseason. And you threw a ball and hit him.
Well, the whole issue was it intentional or not?
Absolutely.
Hit him with a breaking ball. That one was intentional,
yes,
for sure. But were the other two intentional? It looked like he lost control of his fastball, hit him with a breaking ball. And this was a reaction for sure, a message sent back.
This is 19 times playing during the year. This is getting blanked by Madison Bumgarner last year in the wild card, and now being blanked again by Arrieta here.
You see, Sean Rodriguez was at one point being restrained by three Pirates, and he's still barking. Rodriguez, one of Joe Maddon's old players in Tampa.
Managers and the umpires got to get this under control, get the players back on the bench.
Seventh inning fireworks here at PNC.
The only thing I would do different in this instance, if I was Jake Arrieta and the pitcher hit me in the fanny because I've hit two of their players, I would have run to first base. And that might have stopped everything. But once he stopped to talk to Watson, that's when the fireworks started.
I'm sorry, I was staring at the videotape trying to figure out what the words were being said right there in the beginning of that.